On this page, we're going to focus on some select synovial joints. Joints that you should be pretty familiar with, joints that often encounter injury, and joints we often utilize in exercise. Our first select joint is the atlantoaxial joint. That is the joint between C1, which is called the atlas, and C2, which is called the axis. Recall from our previous discussion on movements of synovial joints that this joint is a pivot joint. The movement is rotation. So it's this joint that enables you to shake your head no to the right and to the left. The important components of this joint are the dens of C2 and that articular facet of C1. So the dens remains stationary. That's the pivot point. And then that articular facet of C1 rotates around the dens. Another important joint is called the temporomandibular joint. This is your jaw joint. It is a modified hinge joint, and recall from our discussion on movements of synovial joints that the jaw can do depression and elevation. It can do protraction and retraction, and it can do lateral excursion. Important components of this joint are the condylar processes of the mandible, those two posterior processes that insert into the mandibular fossae of the temporal bone. The shoulder joint is called the glenohumeral joint, and it's a ball and socket joint. Recall from our previous discussion that ball and socket joints can do flexion and extension, abduction and adduction, circumduction and rotation. Important components of this joint are the glenoid cavity. That's the shallow surface of the scapula that receives that head of the humerus. And that's what allows this nice rounded movement of the ball and socket joint. The elbow joint is called the humeroulnar joint. It is also a hinge joint. It can exclusively do flexion and extension. Now, the important components of this joint are that distal epiphysis of the humerus, specifically the trochlea, and then the proximal epiphysis of the ulna has this nice little notch on it that hinges or moves around the trochlea, forming that nice hinge joint. The hip joint is called the acetabulofemoral joint. It's also a ball and socket joint. Like all ball and socket joints, it can do flexion, extension, abduction, adduction, circumduction, and rotation. Now, similar to the shoulder joint, it also has a socket, but this socket is a lot deeper. And that socket is called the acetabulum. That's on the os coxibone. And then the head of the femur sits inside of that acetabulum. Our last and final select joint is probably the one that experiences the most injuries, and that's the knee joint. more correctly called the tibiofemoral joint. It is a hinge joint, and it is the articulation between the distal epiphysis of the femur and the proximal epiphysis of the tibia. There's a lot going on with the knee, so it's worth exploring. Now, the two ligaments on either side of the knee are the lateral collateral ligament, which joins the femur to the fibula, and the medial collateral ligament, which joins the femur to the tibia. So those two collateral ligaments stabilize the knee. There are two other important ligaments, the ACL, or the anterior cruciate ligament, and the PCL, the posterior cruciate ligament, cruciate meaning crossing. Those two ligaments cross and prevent the femur from slipping out of alignment with the tibia. Those experience a lot of injury, particularly the ACL, because of the torsional forces that the knee can experience in certain activities like snowboarding or skiing or landing on your foot while you're trying to slide tackle in soccer, those kind of movements. So that ACL often experiences injury, a torn ACL. You've probably heard of that. A couple other important structures of the knee are the menisci. There are two fibrocartilage discs that sit between the femur and the tibia. The lateral meniscus, of course, is on the lateral side, and the medial meniscus is on the medial side. As all fibrocartilage does, it resists compression. So it's going to absorb the force generated on the tibia by the upper body weight and gravity. All of these joints are important to know. The anatomical term, the joint classification, more specifically within that synovial joint category, that would be ball and socket, hinge, pivot. Also, it's important to know the components of that specific joint.